So, good morning everyone. Today we are going to start with Git and we are going to work on how to install the Git on Windows and how to use it. This would be our first lecture. So, to install the Git, first of all, we have to go to the Chrome. Here, you just search Git install. Let's say for Windows you are searching, you can search Windows. Now, the first website, git-scm, which is sourcecodemanagement.com, will open in front of you. Just open this downloads git-scm. Okay. And now this is an official website of Git. You can download Git from here, directly from here. Now, when you open this, you will see Mac OS, Windows, Linux, Unix. So if you are downloading for Linux, you can click here and you will get a command for that. If you are using for Mac OS, you can click here and you can get the command for that. Whereas in Windows, when you click here, you would be getting the software that need to be downloaded. So here, if your Windows is of 32-bit, in that case, you have to use a different software. Whereas if it's a 64-bit, then you have to use this particular software. Now, let's see what particular bit Windows we are using. Open the file manager. Right click on this PC. Right click and go to the properties. Now, when you go to the properties, you would be able to see the system type. Here it is showing 64-bit. So, in this particular case, I would be using the 64-bit Git for the Windows setup. Okay. Now, this is being installed. Sorry, this is being downloaded. Now, I have to install this particular software. Click on yes. Now, next, it is already installed in my system. So, first it would be removing the previous version and would be installing the latest version here. So, no changes to be done. Install. Okay, just need to click on next, next, next. Keep everything as default and then install it. You don't have to make any kind of changes in the settings or anywhere. Just install it in a direct way. Yeah, this has now been installed. I don't want to view the release notes, so I can just finish it off from here. Right click, click on new and the folder. Let's say I'm creating my project folder. Okay, so as a developer, obviously I would be working on a folder itself. And when you right click, you will see these two new options would be added up. So Git bash is your Git command prompt where we would be putting all our Git commands. So yes, it is as simple as that. And now in the next lecture, we would be looking at how to use these particular Git commands, how we can put the files from our working directory to the staging area and from the staging area to the local repository. Thank you.